Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing great. In today's tutorial, I'm gonna share a list of new Proteus libraries for engineering students. You can download them from the link given in the description of this YouTube video. When you click on that link, you will come to this page on our blog. I have already installed all these libraries, so that's why I can show them in my Proteus software. But if you are using them for the first time, then you have to download these libraries one by one. First of all, we have this Arduino library for Proteus. You can download it from this link. When you click this button, it will take you to another page, and that's an Arduino library for Proteus post, and from that post you can download this library quite easily. Here's the link to download this Arduino library for Proteus, and I have also posted the complete tutorial where I have explained how you can download and install it in your Proteus software. And I have also placed many different simulations. For example, I have also added this simple LED blinking simulation so that you can get an idea how to use these components in Proteus. Okay. So the first one is Arduino library for Proteus. It has 6 boards in it, which are mentioned here: Arduino Uno, etc., Arduino Mini, Pro Mini, and Arduino Nano. Okay, the second one is Genino library for Proteus. And so I'm gonna place both of them in my workspace. Here's our Arduino Uno, and here's our Genino Uno. And how you can use them, it's given in this tutorial. The third one is GPS library for Proteus. GPS is a very useful module which is used in almost every navigation project. GPS is used for detection of user location, and it works in NEMIA format, and it gives longitude and latitude. And if you have installed this library, then you can find it in your components, and here it is. Here's our GPS library for Proteus, and using this TXD and RXD pins, you can receive or send data serially. Okay, the next library is GSM library for Proteus. You can download this library by clicking this button, and I have given detailed instructions how you can download and install this library. And if you have installed it successfully, then when you search for SIM900 in your Proteus, then it will give you these three versions: GSM SIM900 in blue color, this one is in green, and the third one is in red color. So I'm gonna select this blue one, and here's our GSM module SIM900D. The next library is XB library, and I'm gonna search for XB module here. It's taking some time. XB module is an RF module. It is used for wireless communication, and because we can't do the wireless communication in our Proteus software, so we have to use a virtual COM port, and for that I'm using Ultima software. Here's our XB module. I'm gonna place it here, and here it is. It's the XB module series 1 S1. Okay, fourth one was GSM, fifth one was XB library for Proteus, and the sixth library is Bluetooth library for Proteus. Bluetooth modules are also used for wireless communication just like XB modules, but Bluetooth modules use Bluetooth as a way of communication instead of RF, which is radio frequency. These Bluetooth modules are normally used in low range communication projects. These Bluetooth modules also works on serial protocol, and now I'm gonna search it in my Proteus database, and here we have Bluetooth HC05 and HC06 module. So I'm gonna add it here, And here we have our Bluetooth module HC05. It has two pins, TX and RX. We don't need to provide VCC or ground to this module because it's a Proteus simulation and it can work that way. Okay, the next module is DS1 RTC module, and it is used in those projects where you need to get the current time. This module is basically a clock, and you have to program it for once and then just place it in your project, and it will keep on ticking forever. So if you have installed this library, then you have to search for RTC, and here we have our RTC module DS1307. So here's our DS1307 module. I'm gonna place it right here, DS1307 RTC module. It has all these pins: SDA, SCL, SOUT, VCC, ground, X1, X2. I have also posted a tutorial in which I have designed a digital clock using this DS1307 module and Arduino. You can check this link to read more about this project. Next library is LCD library for Proteus. LCDs are already available in Proteus in quite simple form. And again, we have done a little work and designed these new LCD libraries. Okay, the next library is ultrasonic sensor library for Proteus. Ultrasonic sensors are used for obstacle avoidance and hurdle detection. Ultrasonic sensors are used in almost every engineering project related to robotics. It can easily interface with Arduino or PIC microcontroller. So now let's find this ultrasonic sensor in Proteus. Here's our ultrasonic sensor, so I'm gonna place it. The next library is PIR sensor library for Proteus. PIR sensors are used for motion detection. They work on thermal detection. They detect human heat and then detect the presence of human body in the surroundings. They are used for security purposes and are mostly installed in projects like home security system or bank security system. You can download this library by clicking this button, PIR sensor library for Proteus, and if you have installed it correctly, then if you search for this PIR sensor, then we have these four sensors in our library. The first one is in blue color, the second one is green, third one is pink, and the last one is in blue color. So I'm gonna place this one, the light blue color, in my Proteus workspace. Here's our PIR sensor. So now I have to increase the size of my sheet. So I'm gonna set my sheet size to 1510. Okay. The next library is gas sensor library for Proteus. Gas sensors are used for gas leakage detection. It's an essential sensor for most of the industries because mostly gas leakages in industry causes fatal incidents. So using these gas sensors, one can easily detect the gas leakage and can perform some precautions. We have placed these 8 sensors in this library, and you can download this library by clicking this button. And if you have installed it correctly, then you will find gas sensor in Proteus. These are all 8 gas sensors, and I'm gonna place one of them from here in my workspace. Here's our gas sensor MQ2, and it has 3 pins, V in, out, and ground. And this one is our test pin, and if you want to read more about it, then you should click on this link where I have explained in detail how you can simulate this gas sensor in Proteus. Flame sensors are used for fire detection and are normally used for security purposes. As they detect fire, so you must have gotten an idea about its importance. They are used in almost all kinds of projects where fire security is required. And again, if you have installed it correctly, then when you search for this flame sensor, you will find it in your database. and I'm also gonna place it here along with XB. And this is our flame sensor. It again has three pins, ground, out and VCC. And the fourth one is test pin, which is used for testing of this flame sensor. The next library is for vibration sensor. Vibration sensors are used for vibration detection. They are mostly used in those projects where security is our main concern. Moreover, you can also place these sensors on heavy machinery to detect whether there are vibrations in those machineries or not. So you can download this vibration sensor library by clicking this button. And again, if you have installed it correctly, then you will find it in your database. Vibration sensor SW420. So here is our vibration sensor SW420, and I have placed it in my Proteus software, and I'm gonna place it here along with GPS module, and it also has three pins, out, ground and VCC. And here's our test pin to detect the vibration. The next library is for flex sensor. Flex sensors are used for detecting the bending angle. It's normally used in projects where you need to detect the fingers bending. For example, I have once designed a project in which I have to use the sign language and then I have to convert it into text language. Using these flex sensors, I have detected the bending angle of all my fingers, and after that I have converted it into text language. And if you have installed it correctly, then you will find it in your Proteus database, flex sensor library for Proteus. Next one is L298 motor driver library for Proteus. L298 motor driver is used for controlling speed and direction of different motors. We can use it to control DC motors as well as stepper motors. Proteus doesn't have this L298 motor driver in it, but it has L298 module in it. And you can download it by clicking this button. I have posted 16 new Proteus libraries above, and I hope you guys are gonna like them and will use them in your engineering projects. Our team will keep on designing more new Proteus libraries, and I will keep them posted. So subscribe to our YouTube channel and stay tuned. Take care. Bye-bye.